Not all metal roofing systems are created equal. They don't look the same, install the same way, or perform the same, including exposed fastener and standing seam metal roofing products. First, let's take a look at the differences between the two, starting with installation. Exposed fastener metal roofing is just like it sounds. It uses an exposed fastener to attach the panel to the substrate, while a standing seam panel uses hidden hardware under the vertical leg to attach the panel to the substrate. Exposed fastener panels are usually made of a lighter gauge material than standing seam, and often comes in wider panels, which means they will go down faster. Fewer panels equals less installation time. Standing seam panels are often 12, 16, 18 inches wide, somewhere in that range, while exposed fastener panels can be up to 3 feet in width. When it comes to paint, a lot of exposed fastener systems use an SMP paint system, whereas standing seam often uses PVDF paint systems, which is just a better overall coating. SMP is a good paint system, PVDF is a great paint system with better color retention and chalking properties. However, it's important to note that you can get a PVDF paint on an exposed fastener roof, it's just not as common. Going back to installation, exposed fastener metal roofing often uses a foam closure at the ridge, eave, and hip section, which is typically easier to install than metal closures that standing seam uses. This is because foam closures are preformed to fit the profile already, while it takes a little more knowledge and time to install the metal closures of standing seam metal roofing. When panels are installed and engaged, the exposed fastener engagement is a lap. For standing seam, the engagement is either a snap or a seam. When it comes to panel length, a lot of exposed fastener systems are limited to be around 25 feet. Depending on the profile, some of them go up to 40, but always make sure you follow the manufacturer's recommended length. For standing seam systems, the panels aren't pinned to the substrate like an exposed fastener system is, so they can be extremely long. We've seen panels that can go 100, 200 feet long for large commercial buildings, and we see that very often. With exposed fastener panels, we do recommend that you check the screws every few years, because with that expansion and contraction, it can cause the screws to unseat themselves and back out of the hole, which could cause a potential leak. Exposed fastener panels are extremely strong when it comes to withstanding high winds. This is all based on the panel type, screw pattern, material, and substrate. So again, this is not a one-size-fits-all statement. But I will say that there are standing seam systems that also have amazing uplift performance. It really depends on the panel you choose and how it's installed. So make sure that you're following your manufacturer's recommendations, you have the appropriate testing and engineering that is required for your area and your region, so there's no guesswork. We recommend something above a 312 pitch for exposed fastener metal roofing, so the water has less chance to back up on the roof system over time and possibly penetrate the holes that the fasteners create. For standing seam systems, there are low slope options as well that can go down to a 212, sometimes even lower, depending on your needs and your installation. Generally, exposed fastener systems are going to be cheaper because they go down faster due to wider panel widths, there's less manufacturing time because there's fewer panels to get out there, and there are less accessories that need to be installed because you don't have to worry about things like clips. Regionally, this makes a difference as well because some regions have cheaper materials and different types of installation costs. Some manufacturers in your area may only offer exposed fastener metal roofing. Some installers may only install exposed fastener metal roofing. It just depends on your region and what's available to you. For standing seam systems overall, you're gonna be paying a more premium price than an exposed fastener roof. But with exposed fastener, you may end up paying that initial price difference in maintenance later down the road. Typically, it's agreed that standing seam systems will have a longer life than an exposed fastener system. And it comes down to having hidden hardware that's not exposed to the elements, comes down to using metal closures rather than foam closures. And it also comes down to being able to have that thermal expansion and contraction not trapped within the system. So for those reasons, you know, we often see standing seam systems lasting longer. But again, it all comes down to how it's installed and the types of products you're using, the paint system, the material, the thickness, all that plays a part. Let's talk about when it's a good option to buy an exposed fastener metal roof. If you're someone who wants that that ribbed look, that metal roof look. It doesn't have the budget for standing seam, but you still want a metal roof, then exposed fastener metal roofing might be a great choice for you. It's often done DIY. People will take their exposed fastener metal roofing projects on themselves because you can pick up the panels from a big box store or a local roofing supplier, and the flashing zones are easier to contend with. Standing seam metal roofing is a good choice if you like the look of metal roofing with hidden fasteners. You can afford the more expensive price tag, and you want the longevity of that standing seam system. And lastly, again, it comes down to that performance. Where is your building located? What types of winds and environmental elements does it have to withstand? That's gonna play into whether you want exposed fastener or standing seam. Again, this is just a basic overview of exposed fastener and standing seam metal roofing. There's a lot more that we could go into, and I want you to comment down below if you have a specific project, a specific question that pertains to this topic that we can help answer, or check out our other content at SHEFFIELDMetals.com. Thanks for watching here, everybody. I'm Thad Barnett. We'll catch you next time.